We are quite pleased with the results over the first half of this year. The net profit ended at 1.1 billion euros, which is slightly lower than over the first half of 2013. But if you exclude the resolution levy, which was related to the nationalization of SNS Bank, actually our results were even slightly higher than in 2013. So from a P&L perspective, quite pleasing. Balance sheet pretty much flat, a slight increase of our lending, which is a reflection of the slow recovery of the economy in the Netherlands. And both the capital and liquidity position continue to be very strong. I think there are three major items which had an consequence for the net P&L. A very good development is the continuing improvement of the net interest margin. We see that the very low margins we were confronted with in the years before the crisis, before 2008, are now being becoming better. So margins on mortgages, but also on SMEs, are slightly better than we were used to. More important is the cost development. The operational cost decreased by 7%. This is a consequence of the restructuring program we started in our domestic operation about 2 years ago. And this downward trend in terms of cost will also continue in the next couple of years. Finally, and that's a negative one, are the bad debt expenses. We took almost 1.2 billion provision on bad loans, dominated by the CRE portfolio. The commercial real estate area is still struggling domestically. And we expect that that will also continue in the next calendar year. The total bad debt expenses amounted to 1.2 billion euros, which is higher than in the first half of 2013. Good news is that it is a little bit lower than the second half of 2013. And given the development of our special asset management portfolio, I really think that we have seen the top in terms of bad debt expenses. So the recovery of the economy is being reflected by a limited inflow of in special asset management and a bigger outflow. But anyway, 1.2 billion is a big number, dominated by CRE. Fairly close to 600 million was related to CRE portfolio, predominantly in the Dutch marketplace. And the CRE market is struggling and will continue to struggle in the next 12 to 18 months. We expect that it will start to bottom out in the second half of 2015. The other areas of the portfolio are performing quite good. An area of continuous concern, of course, is the horticulture business, not only because the business is already struggling for quite some time, but also the recent Russia crisis does mean a further difficult position for that particular sector. But otherwise, the portfolio, the loan book, has performed quite well. The very good news is that the losses we have experienced in our mortgage book are pretty close to zero. The most important phenomenon regarding capital was the implementation of CRD4, starting on January 1st of this year. As a consequence, the Core Tier 1 ratio per January 1st of this year was 12.5. We have seen a slight increase to 12.6% halfway the year. I should remind that in these numbers, the net results over the first half are not included, and that represents roughly 30 basis points. And also the expected close of the sale of BGZ somewhere in the next number of weeks is not included in these numbers, and that's another 40 basis points. So all in all, the Core Tier 1 ratio looks pretty good. Total capital, I think the story is even better. By year-end 2013, we were close to 20%. Due to the adjustment related to CRD4, that number dropped to 18.8, and we are back to almost 20% halfway the year. So that's all being compensated in the first 6 months by issuing particular Tier 2 instruments. Liquidity-wise, the most important ratios are the LCR and the NSFR. We have very high ratios at this moment. I think you can argue that the liquidity position of the bank is even stronger than half a year ago. even though our liquidity buffer is a little bit lower than 6 months ago. But that's also due to the composition of the balance sheet. We had a long-term funding plan of 20 billion for this calendar year, and halfway the year we are almost at 20 billion euros. So the second half, you can almost argue, will be fairly relaxing. We can more or less follow what the market is, how the market is behaving. We will definitely be continue to be active in the senior market, maybe also anticipating the year 2015. Another area we have been active in is in the tier two markets. We have raised additional tier two in the first 6 months of the year. And that's also one of the key reasons why our total capital ratio ended at fairly close to 20%. We have not been active in the additional tier one market, even though percentage-wise that number decreased over the first 6 months, due to the fact that we called a couple of the old-style hybrid instruments. That is particularly due to the fact that the tax situation regarding the additional tier ones was unclear in the Dutch marketplace. However, since a new tax law passed the parliament very recently, you can expect Rabobank to become active in the additional tier one market as well. Maybe in the second half of the year, but otherwise in the years to come, just to replace the old-style hybrids that will be called at certain dates. Very pleasing was the development regarding the Rabobank certificates. We listed these instruments at the Amsterdam Stock Exchange in February of this year. And the way these instruments traded over the first couple of months in the market was quite pleasing. And I think it's very good news that with these instruments, Rabobank has access to the capital markets for common equity tier one as well. We have no plans regarding future issuance, but at least we have the opportunity. And that's, I think, very good news. For Rabobank, the performance of the Dutch economy is key. And we do see in 2014, for the first time in many years, a recovery of the economy. So that's good news. And on the back of it, you might expect that also Rabobank's performance will see a further improvement. As part of the Dutch economy, the Dutch housing market, the recovery is probably even stronger. And since that's such an important part of the portfolio of the bank, we are quite pleased with these numbers. There are still a couple of uncertainties. And an important one is the outcome of the AQR and stress test. We are confident that, of course, we will pass the tests, but what the ultimate consequences will be, we don't know. We simply don't know at this moment in time. And another uncertainty is, of course, the geopolitical situation in some parts of the world, in particular what's happening right now in the Ukraine/Russian border zone. The consequence of the blockades on some parts of the Dutch economy are quite severe. I already mentioned the horticulture business, but potentially there are a few more economic sectors that could be hurt by that particular situation. And we are going to follow that, of course, very closely. So all in all, we think we have good results over the first half. And given the economic circumstances, we are quite optimistic about the near future.